When I arrived home in the U.S. for Thanksgiving last year, I was excited to see all my friends and family. After all, it has been 2.5 years since I've seen any of them. But I knew things were going to be different. The country was so divided, and the church as a Christian witness to the nation about Jesus is as well. The tension was tangible. When I walked into my hometown's local diner with my face mask on, which was required by Illinois state law, some older gentleman made a sheep sound at me. Now, this wasn't an outward burst of affirmation at being one of God's elected sheep, but rather an overwhelmingly public display of disapproval. I knew this community was divided. And here, they were displaying their disunity publicly. After the election of Donald J. Trump and then Brexit, we thought we couldn't be more divided. But now a global pandemic has destroyed the lives of many of our loved ones. Misinformation about the virus, masks, and vaccines made us even more divided. How could we be one? We live in a time when if you disagree with someone, you shouldn't be friends or even speak to them. On social media, some people are even canceled. It becomes hard to live in peace when we are so divided. This idea of disunity is nothing new. This isn't a result of postmodernity or the rise of secularism, but rather the continued state of humanity. Scholars tell us that in the first century, wars occurred because of tribal disagreements that led to whole villages being wiped out. Tribes holding superiority complexes did the unthinkable torture to others, showing this complex to be correct. Therefore, when God calls his people to have his supernatural oneness, he is telling the ancient church that fully understood this context, and he is telling us this now as well. The central concern is oneness, unity. It is multidimensional, oneness with God and oneness with others. Its foundation is that divine glory is to be seen and shared in Jesus. We have seen his glory, the prologue states in John 1:14. Glory was a way of speaking of God's being. This unity is not any unity. It is not a contrived peace or collaboration. It is rooted in what Bishop Tom Wright and Archbishop Rowan Williams call the event of Jesus. That life opened a window on God's being. This oneness, which John speaks of, is a deep longing for togetherness. We try to understand the relationship between the Father and the Son, but it is difficult. And some may say impossible to fully grasp. But at the same time, God calls us to try to grasp it, to try to live as one, as they are one. This supernatural unity, frankly, seems impossible. But the text gives the reader unction to attempt to be disciples that are one for the sake of the gospel of Jesus. Maybe because the mission set before them was so hard, God knew they needed to be united to accomplish that mission. To accomplish something, you must put all disagreements aside for the one mission that is bigger and greater than you and your life. The ultimate purpose of Jesus' prayer in this passage is effectiveness of the believer's corporate witness to the world. The effectiveness of the believer's corporate witness to the world. Therefore, this part of the prayer is not about the congregation's fellowship or oneness with each other, though that is extremely important, but our evangelism. Yet what areas usually receive more attention in our congregations? We are to bring people to know and love God and His people. In what practical ways can we show the love of God to people? One way is not to cancel people for their mistakes or their views. It's easy to create a culture of canceling people or organizations out of a sense of justice and care. But that does not show love or oneness that is of God. Unity is not an extra. It is the essence of what it means to be a Christian. Key words like reconciliation and atonement assume centrality. Did John imagine uniformity? It is striking that the gospel depicts considerable diversity in responses to Jesus. Yet he leaves out no one. We don't cancel people, but we accept people for being created, just as he tells us to do. This is a small but vital step on the road to making unity possible and becoming a church for everyone. Amen.